Today's course is a bit different to a normal orienteering course in that everybody starts together, so that's going to be really exciting for the competitors actually. At the same time, it's a really technical area, so really, really difficult. Difficult to navigate through, so there's a pressure of racing with a bunch of different people as well as the technical element, which makes it a really special event today. I think it really highlights the best competitors, not only the ones who can navigate but the ones who can do it under pressure.
Yep, and considering that it's also a mass start event today, do you expect that there'll be close finishes, or do you think there'll be a few individuals breaking away from the pack?
It all comes down to a mass start race. They've got three loops. The first two loops are varied. The last loop is common. And so given it's common last loop, look, I'd really would expect to see a few people finishing together and to see a few sprint finishes.
So Shep's really got to put the hammer down if he's going to get him. And it doesn't look like he will. So we've got Simon Uphill coming back and coming in second place and David Shepherd in third.
2010 Silver National Orienteering League kicked off in Victoria with three races over the weekend. Stage 1 was a mass start multi-loop race in the complex gold mining terrain at Chewton Diggings. A well-planned event area enabled spectators to see competitors at 7 times during the race. Organiser Darren Meeking from Melbourne Forest Races succeeded in bringing the action of the forest to the public, while Rob Lewis and course setter Simon Goddard provided expert commentary. There were few surprises in the senior divisions, with the favourites proving too strong. Julian Dent won by a clear margin from Simon Uphill and David Shepherd, who had fought it out all the way to the line. It was closer in the women's race, but the results still finished as expected, with Catherine Newell's just ahead of Shannon Jones and Vanessa Round. Leon Keeley had a comfortable victory in the Junior Elite men's class, while Georgia Parsons surprised some with a breakthrough win in Junior Elite women.